In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ. My dear friends, today we will read the letter of Apostle Paul to Corinthians, first letter, chapter 5, until the 6th chapter, probably verse 9. Let us pray to the Holy Spirit. Heavenly King, Advocate, Spirit of Truth, you are everywhere present. Fill all things, treasure your blessing, bestower of life. Come and dwell within us. Cleanse us of all that defiles us. As a good one, save our souls. My dear friends, the chapter 4 of the first letter to Corinthians, the last verse, 21, Apostle Paul, you know, he found the problems in Corinthians church. They are very rich, but there is no unity among themselves, and there is sexual immorality. In the chapter 4, the last verse is saying, Apostle Paul is asking them, I will come to you. Do you want me, shall I come to you with punishment or in spirit of love and gentleness? About punishment, he will not hit anyone. But if you remember the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, when Apostle Paul and Barnabas, when they approach to one place and there was a proconsul, a nice person, Sergius Paulus, and he was under the influence of Barisus, of the man who was having like a bad spirit, and that man was giving wrong advice to him. And Apostle Paul, he saw that, and he stopped that man to do his rash job. And that Barisus, regardless that he had such a nice name, it's a chapter 13, the Acts of the Apostles, he became blind immediately. Everyone was surprised. The people brought him out, and proconsul Sergius Paulus had been baptized. And surprised how strong the right spirit, the spirit of Jesus Christ is. Apostle Paul here, he is mentioning probably the same event. He wants to give them a hint. He is saying, don't you know about what's happened? Do you want the same thing will happen again? He was a jealous man. He was a zealous man. He was as much as he was zealous for the Moses law, when he had been converted, it's chapter 9, the Acts of the Apostles, the same way he was proclaiming Jesus, and he was intolerant to sin. The problem of Corinthians, it was tolerantness. They were too much tolerant to everyone, and that is sometimes Christians' problem, the problem of Christians, because if you are tolerating, if you are tolerating sin, tolerance to sin, it's not good for heavenly kingdom. Chapter 5. Now, it is actually being said that there is sexual immorality among you, so terrible that not even the heathen would be qualified of it. Even pagans would be doing that. You are doing the worst things. I am told that a man is sleeping with his stepmother. That time there was a concubine in Roman Emperor. The father could have a younger wife than his son. Some of the fathers used to have that, and that kind of sin had been forbidden by government and also by the church. How then you can be proud? On the contrary, you should be filled with sadness, and the man who has done such a thing should be expelled from your fellowship. And even though I am far away from you in body, still I am there with you in spirit. And as though I were be there with you, I have, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, already passed judgment on the man who has done this terrible thing. You know, Apostle Paul is not present there, but his spiritual power was so powerful Stop even those things being in distance. As you meet together, and I meet you in my spirit by the power of our Lord Jesus present with us, you are to hand this man over to Satan for his body to be destroyed so that his spirit may be saved in the day of the Lord. Therefore, it's the power of resurrected Jesus Christ will stop Satan in such a way. But we have to be really righteous and faithful to Jesus, to serve Jesus like Apostle Paul was serving. It is not right for you to be proud. You know the saying, a little bit of yeast makes the whole batch of dough rise. You must remember the old yeast of sin so that you will be entirely pure. You know, that little piece of yeast he is calling the previous life before knowing Jesus Christ. We, you, they, those people had to stop your previous life and then follow Jesus Christ. Then you will be like a new batch of dough without any yeast. As indeed I know you actually are. For our Passover festival is ready now that Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us celebrate our Passover then not with bread having the old yeast of sin and wickedness, but with the bread that has no yeast, the bread of purity and truth. You know, that bread is a Christian life. There is no pride in that life, but there is holiness and eternal life. My dear friends, this is amazing. In the letter that I wrote to you, I told you not to associate with immoral people. Now, I did not mean pagans who are immoral or greedy or are thieves or who worship idols. To avoid them, you would have to get out of the world completely. What I meant was that you should not associate with a person who calls himself a believer, but is immoral or greedy, or worships idols, or is a slanderer, or a drunkard, or a thief. Don't even sit down to eat with such a people. Now he's putting on the same scale, idol worshippers, slanderers, drinkers and thieves, and sexual immorality. And the same punishment is for that. Just remember this, we are Christians, we have to follow Jesus Christ. We have to be in unity because there was a lack of unity, and after that, sexual immorality comes. After all, it is not of my business to judge outsiders. Apostle Paul is saying that the Christians who are claiming to be Christians, who had been baptized, if they continue to live old style of life, don't eat even with those people. Not with outsiders, because you will have to leave everyone. But the aim of Apostle Paul was to bring outsiders inside to the church by the moral life and Christian life, not by living like them. Tolerance to the sin is very bad. The problem those Christians in Corinth and our problem today, it's not intolerance to sin, but it's a tolerance. We cannot tolerate sin. God will judge them. But should you not judge the members of your own fellowship? And the scripture says, remove the evil person from your group. Therefore, Apostle Paul started to talk, and I'm going to read a couple more verses from chapter 6 of the first letter to Corinthians, that he's advising, he's requiring that Christians, they cannot go to unbelievers to be judged by them, because they're going to use Satan's approach. You could pay them and they will tell you whatever you want to hear, justify you, and your innocent brother will be suffering. If any of you have a dispute with another Christian, how dare you go before if any one of you have a dispute with another Christian, how dare you go before he then judge instead of letting God's people settle the matter? Don't you know that God's people will judge the world? Don't go to unbelievers. Well then, if you are to judge the world, aren't you capable of judging small matters? Do you not know that we shall judge the angels? You know, one of the psalms, it was written in that psalm that I am your God and you are gods, but there is a name, Elohim. You are Elohim. When you are judging, be like God and you will do and have God's qualities. How much more then the things of life, things of this life? If such matter come up, are you going to make them to be settled by people who have no standing in the church? If those people have no standing in the church, if they are not following Christ's moral, then they will use their own philosophy to judge you and rules. Shame on you. Surely there is at least one wise person in your fellowship who can settle a dispute between fellow Christians. Instead, one Christian goes to court against another and lets unbelievers judge the case. The very fact that you have legal disputes among yourselves shows that you have failed completely. Any disputes, if there is lack of unity, it means we failed spiritually. Would it not be better for you to be wrong? Would it not be better for you to be wrong? Like, it's better to be wrong? It's better not to go on judgment, because not going on judgment and being robbed, it's like you are in good standing and you are holy, because you didn't go to use judgment of unbelievers. Therefore, being wrong, would you not be better to you to be robbed? It's a positive matter. It means to stay with the gospel. In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ. Glory be forever.